फुल्ली कॉन्सेप्ट का,
यस
कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ योर सी अर बेटा फर्स्ट वन आई टेल यू विद द हेल्प ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स ओनली. Say for example, this is your ceiling, and say for example, there is one pulley here right now, like this, and this is passing through a string here right now. There is one more pulley here, and it has been connected to somewhere here. And this one is one more passing here, and there is one more pulley here, and this one is again connected to this one like this. Okay.
Yes.
There is a block of mass, say for example here M, and there is another block here, say for example another condition. Okay.
Okay, sir.
This one is say for example M2, and this one is say for example of here M1. Okay. And if I am saying that this body is moving down with acceleration A2, and this body is also moving down with acceleration A1, and both of them I am taking in the same direction, but which is not possible. But in the final answer, we'll get the condition or we'll get the direction in which is A1 and which is A2. Okay, na? Okay.
Yes.
See this one. Now, what is the rule you see, beta? I hope you remember it. Last time also I told you. It's very simple rule. Summation of your T dot your A bar. Tension dot A bar must be equal to zero. Okay, if velocities yes. are given, or summation of your T bar dot your V bar must be equal to zero. Is it clear?
Yes.
So this is your basic condition. Okay, so that means sum of all the tensions dot, as it is a dot product. So in dot product, you know, A bar dot V bar will be equal to how much beta? Mod A mod V into cos theta.
Yes,
isn't it? Like say for example T bar dot your A bar will be equal to mod of T mod of your A bar into your cos of your theta.
Yes,
theta will be what? Angle between A bar and B bar.
Yes.
So if this is this one and this is this one, if this is say for example A bar and this is say for example T, angle between them will become theta. Okay, now if I take the tension is in this direction and another one is in this direction. Okay, so this one is T and this one is say for example E. So what is the angle between them? 180 degrees.
180 degrees. Yes, okay. Sir.
So what is our basic rule to do this type of a problem? Sum of all the tensions dot your A bar must be equal to your zero. Must be equal to your zero. Or summation of all the T dot your V must be equal to your zero part of creation. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now let us try to give the tensions for this one. Come on. Now give me the tensions for this one, beta. Now what are the tensions for this one? There is how many strings are there? You tell me. From here to here, there is one single string, beta.
Yes, sir. One.
Here, whatever the string is been passing, so string which is been passing through these three pulleys is one single pulley, one single string, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So whatever the tension you are developing in this one, say, beta. If there is a T here, there will be your T here. There is a T here. This is also your T here. And here, if it is T, tension is always away from the body, beta. Make sure of that part.
Okay, sir.
Tension is always away from the body. So this is your tension T, this is your tension T, and this is your tension T. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Now see, if above is say for example 5 and above is also 5, how much I required it down to balance it? 10 gada?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? Above is 5 and above is 5, that means above is 10. To balance it, how much I need it down? 10 gada?
10, sir. Yes.
Means here, if it is T, in this one you see right now, if this is T and this is T, how much I have need require here right now? 2T?
Yes, sir.
Here also 2T. And here also if it is T and T, here this will become for me 2T and this one is also becoming for me 2T. Clear?
Yes.
Now tell me what is the weight of this body, beta? M2 into G. And what is this body? M1 into your G. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
What I'll do this one, you see. How I to use the tensions T dot your. Now take the mass M1 first. Okay, take the mass M1. Now tell me on M1, what are the forces acting?
Sir, there is downward MG, sir, and there's tension.
But I need in T and A. Where is A?
A is downwards.
So that means for M1, if I'm taking right now here, like say, this is your, say for example of your M1. This is your M1. So M1 acceleration is downward direction, but how much is that one? A1. And this one is how much right now? For the mass of your M1. Tension is how much for me? 2T. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I'm talking about your M2. Now I'm talking about your M2. Now tell me for M2. M2 above is 2T, acceleration is, because I need the relation between tension and acceleration only. 2T is above, A2 is in your downward direction, isn't it?
Yes.
So A in this direction and this one is in this direction. This one is how much? 2T. And here down is nothing but A2. Now, can you tell me what is angle between these two?
Sir, it's 180 degrees. Yes.
Sir, also how much? 180 degrees.
Same 180.
Now I told you what is the formula. Summation. Summation and any tensions and any tensions we need to go on, add it.
Yes.
That means what? So this is nothing but of your 2T into your A1 into cos of your 180 plus this one is your 2T into your A2 into your cos of your 180. Must be equal to how much? Zero.
Yes.
నీకు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేపిస్తున్నాం కాబట్టి రైట్ అండ్ టైం పడుతుంది. వన్స్ యు బికమ్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ ఇట్ విల్ బికమ్ ఈజీ ఫర్ us టు డు.
కాస్
180 ఇస్ హౌ మచ్?
మైనస్ 1 సర్.
సో ఇట్ విల్ బి 2t ఇంటు యువర్ a1. వాట్ మైనస్?
Yes sir.
Isn't it? Here also place it 2t into a2. This is how much? Cos 180.
Same minus 1 sir. So again
this will be 2t into your a2 that will be equal to 0.
Yes.
If minus goes on other side, this will be equal to how much beta? 2t into your a1. This is minus is equals to 2t into your a2.
Yes, sir.
Anything is getting cancelled. This 2t will get cancelled.
Yes.
That means minus of a1 is equals to your a2.
Yes, sir.
That means what I can say? A1 must be equal to minus of your a2.
Yes, sir.
That means whatever the direction we have assumed. Whatever direction we have assumed, is it correct or wrong?
Downward direction there.
Both negative. Of them are downward direction only, na?
Yes, sir.
So here A1 and A1 are in the same direction. But how, what I got here, A1 must be equal to minus of A2.
Yes.
That means what? If A1 is moving down, A2 should move up, kada?
Yes, sir.
Got an idea?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That means they should be in opposite direction on earth. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Got an idea how to do such type of a problems?
Yes, sir. Got it.
So let us try to practice now this one. Rule are the main, kada?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Let me give you one more problem. Now I'm not writing everything in detail. I'm just going on doing the problem part of relation so that will reduce our time. So here there is one point right now. Okay. And here this one is been connected to one block right now. Sorry. Okay. And there is one more string like this here right now. There is one more pulley like this here. Okay, somewhere here right now like this. And this one is again connected to here. And there is one block here right now. This is your block. Clear?
Yes.
This one is say for example M2. And this one is say for example M1. So I need the question for me. Find relation between A1 and A2. Find relation between A1 and A2. If I say that this is moving with A2 in the upward direction and this is moving down with your A1 in the downward direction. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
I need the relation between them. Now, can you tell me? First, we need to write the tensions, beta. Be careful about your tensions. Okay?
Yes,
now, tell
sir.
Me. What is the tension here? Yeah, this is your T here.
Yes.
This is also T. So, here also this is T and this is also your T. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So here how much it will be?
2T. 2T, sorry. Yes.
So this 2T. One is also your 2T.
2T.
Here also 2T. Is it 2T? And yes. Here also your 2T. Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
Now if you see carefully, this is your T. This is your T. This is also T and this is also T. This is arrow markup. This is arrow markdown. This is arrow markup. This is arrow. Now on M1, how many T's are acting?
On M1, there is 3T, sir.
3T, very good. On M2?
On M2, it is only T, sir.
Okay, T. So now this is M1, beta. Now M1, acceleration is in downward direction, A1.
Yes, sir.
And tension is in upward, how much? 3T.
Clear? Yes, sir.
Now M2, for M2, acceleration is upward, A2. Tension T is also upward, T. Sorry, T is in the upward, okay?
Yes.
Both of them are upward. That means here angle is how much? Zero. Here angle is how much? 180 degrees.
180.
Now, can you add them? Can you add them? How much it is? 3T into your A1 into your cos 180 plus this will be equal to how much? T into your A2 into your cos of 0 degrees. Must be equal to 0. Cos 0 is how much?
Cos 0 is 1, sir.
1. Cos 180?
Minus 1, sir.
So it is a 3T into your A1 minus, can I write?
Yes, sir.
This one is how much for me? Plus T into your A2 must be equal to 0. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
So this will be equal to much minus of 3t into your a1 is equals to your minus of t into your a2. Agreed?
Yes.
This t and this t will get cancelled. This minus will get cancelled. So what is the answer? 3 times of a1 is equals to your a2.
Yes, sir.
That means therefore I can write, if I'm asking a1, so a1 will be equal to how much beta? A2 by 3?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So this is the way, how do we write the answers for this one? Okay, what an
sir.
Idea.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
You rule used to have Martha Mandra, bro?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Sure. So, if you have any children, you just want to report them in the.
Okay, sir.
Okay, na?
Yes, sir.
I'm not going to give. Last year, I will check. No, sir, go through. If we can get it out, it will be damn good for you.
Okay, sir.
Okay, na? Next one. Concept of fully block system. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Concept of your fully block system. Okay. The question is, if pulley is movable. If pulley is movable, then how to solve problems? Clear?
Yes, sir.
In the previous cases, the pulley was fixed here, everywhere. It was not moving.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? But now we are talking about a condition where the pulley is also moving with certain velocity. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Let's say, for example, this is one pulley. Okay. And here, this pulley is moving up with certain velocity, say for example, 2 meters per second. Got it?
Yes, sir.
And there is one block here right now for this one, like this. And there is one more block right now connected to this one, somewhat like this. Okay? And yes, to this sir. One, there is a block attached like this. There is also one more block attached to this one like this. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Say for example, if this is your A and this is your B. If A is moving down with 4 meters per second, and what is the velocity of your B? If the velocity of the pulley, this is the pulley, kada? And the velocity of the pulley, this will become for me velocity of the pulley. Clear?
Yes, sir.
This is your question. Now, if you see it very carefully, beta, is the length of the string is completely constant, beta?
No, sir.
Length of the string, is it constant or is it changing?
Sir, it's constant. The length of the string is constant.
Length is always constant, isn't constant. It? Like say for example, yes, if I take some reference, this if this is your X1, this will be your X2.
Yes, sir.
So can I say that X1 plus of your X2 will be equal to how much? Total length of the string?
Yes, sir.
So if I differentiate this one, dx1 by your dt plus of your dx2 by your dt must be equal to your d into your length L divided by your dt. Length is a constant. Differentiation of any constant is always zero.
Yes, sir.
Now, x is with respect to what beta? A is with respect to pulley. X1 is between A and P, na beta?
Yes, sir.
Now, dx by dt will give me what? Velocity?
Yes, sir.
So velocity of A with respect to pulley, I can write, plus velocity of the B with respect to pulley must be equal to zero. Clear?
Yes, sir.
That means velocity of A with respect to P will be equal to minus of velocity of B with respect to pulley. Now, late velocity, yes. How do you write beta? Late velocity with respect to B means how do you write? Relative velocity with respect to B. A with respect to B at the last one, VA minus VB.
Okay, yes, sir.
Relative one again,
yes, sir.
Velocity of A with respect to B and end also.
VB minus VB, yes,
sir. VA minus VB.
VA minus VB, yes, sir.
That is equals to minus of VB minus of VB.
VB, yes, sir.
Isn't it? Now, if I remove the minus sign, VA minus of VB will be equal to minus of VB. Remove the bracket. This will become for me VP. All VP terms you take on one side. So this will become for me VA plus VB will be equal to. This will become for me how much? VP plus of your VP. That means this will become for me 2 times of your VP. Okay. That means yes, velocity of the pulley will be equal to how much beta? Velocity of your A. This will be equal to your velocity of your A plus velocity of your B divided by 2. Can I write like this?
Yes.
That is our Brahmastra to do the problems related to this one bit.
Okay, sir.
This is the standard formula which you need to remember. Velocity of your A with respect to your P will be equal to, if it is movable, it is your VA plus of your VB divided by your 2. Clear?
Yes.
If it is an acceleration, similarly, for acceleration, how do you write beta? In the place of V, I'll write AP, acceleration of A plus acceleration of the B divided by 2.
Yes, sir.
If I differentiate the velocity with respect to time, I'll be getting acceleration.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it? So this is the formulas which you need to remember. These are the shortcut formulas. A derivation is no use for you right now.
Okay,
sir. The only thing is how I got that relation. Now, whenever you're doing movable pulley problem, these two formulas you should always fix in mind.
Okay, sir.
Now you should not forget because you don't get the chance again to repeat. Got it?
Yes.
So whenever you're doing movable pulleys, what is the velocity of A, velocity and acceleration of the pulley center? These two formulas should always come in the mind.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now see the sign convention. Sign convention. What is? In the direction of pulley. Yeah. In the direction of the pulley, we'll take positive beta.
Okay, sir.
Opposite to it, we take negative.
Clear? Negative. Yes.
Now do this problem. Velocity of pulley is how much? 2 meters per second.
Yes, sir.
Chapna na, am I in the dalga now?
Nothing, sir.
What is the velocity of pulley? Velocity of the pulley in upward direction is 2 meters per second.
2 meters per second.
Velocity of A is in this direction, downward direction, 4 meters per second. Opposite to that one, gada.
Yes, sir.
So I can use this formula. VP is equal to VA plus VB.
Yes, sir.
So what is VP? VP is equals to your VA plus of your VB divided by 2. Velocity of pulley is how much? 2. Velocity of A is opposite to the pulley.
Minus 4.
Don't give anything
plus
to
the unknown. You
give VB divided by 2. Clear?
Yes, sir.
2 into 2, 4. That is equals to minus 4 plus four of your plus VB. So velocity of the B will be equal to how much?
8 meter per second, sir.
Plus eta, minus eta.
Plus 8, sir.
8 meter per second. Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So what is that means? Is it positive?
Moving
what
down.
Do you mean by that one? VB, I got positive. That means it is direction. It is moving up or it is moving down?
Upwards, sir.
Upwarded kada, because we got positive.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Very good. Now I'm going on giving you the numericals. Go on, give me the answers for this one.
Yes, sir.
This is your pulley. And this pulley is moving up with velocity of 4 meter per second. There is a block here right now, B. And there is another block, say, for example, A. If velocity of A is in the upward direction with your 6 meter per second, what is the velocity of the B? Chappo.
This is upward. Sir, then we are going to get the velocity of B, we are going to get a negative, sir.
See, what is velocity of pulley? 4. Velocity of A is 6 plus velocity of B divided by 2. Then
yes, sir.
4 to the 8. 8 is equals to 6 plus of your VB. So how much I am getting VB? VB
two,
will
sir.
Be equal to?
Minus 2, sir.
How much?
Minus 2, sir.
Sure.
We'll get 2, sir,
VB,
but it's moving down.
This one. Yeah.
It's moving downwards.
So how much it is? 2
minus
meters
two,
per second.
Sir. This Clear? Is 2 and... Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
Sure.
Sir, so VB finally would be minus 2, right, sir?
Yeah, minus 10 indicates only direction, Gada.
Direction, yes, sir. That's what I'm saying.
Isn't it? If it is direction, means it will be in this direction. Downward direction,
Gada? Downward direction. Yes,
got it?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Next one. And this is your pulley. And this is moving with 4 meter per second. And here there is a block right now here. And another end is being connected to the fixed end right now like this. This is
okay.
Fixed end. This is a point A. So what is the velocity of your E? Up to what we need to do, we need to assume this one as B. B is a Tresca, but a velocity of the B, we take it as 0.
0. Okay, sir.
Okay? Now,
yes,
again,
sir.
Velocity of the pulley will be equal to velocity of A plus velocity of the B divided by 2. Velocity
eight,
of the pulley
sir.
Is 4. Velocity of A we need to calculate. Velocity of B is 0 divided
zero.
By 2. So, velocity
eight.
Of A will be equal to how much? 8 meter per
second. 8 meter per
second. Positive we got?
Yes, sir.
Positive means it is moving in this direction.
Positive means it's moving upwards, sir.
You can write such type of answers, Gada, clear? Ga?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Now think and tell me the answer. Take a rough paper and try to do. I'm just increasing the number of pulleys. There is a pulley here right now. Okay.
Yes.
And here this one is fixed to this one. And here there is attached to one more. And this part has been pulling this one. And this is attached to somewhere here right now. Here. Okay. And here I'm having one more pulley like this. And here also I'm having one more pulley like this. Clear?
Yes.
Now, to this one, there is another wire which has been fixed. And here it has been fixed here. And here there is one more block, say for example A. And there is your another block here right now, say for example B. There is another block here, like say for example A. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So I'll take just A, B, the C, this one.
Okay, sir.
Because I've taken B already. So A, B, and C. Sirvina? Another question
yes,
is
sir.
Velocity of C is how much? Velocity of the B is in upward direction. Velocity of the B is 3 meter per second upward direction. Velocity of A is in the downward direction with your 4 meter per second. And this is the pulley P1. This is your pulley P2. And this is your pulley P. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if you see this pulley P1, is it similar to this one?
Yes, sir. Same P1
so
is also
I can get the velocity of pulley, Gada, because pulley P1 is movable, Gada.
Yes, sir.
So, because it is connected to this one, the pulley may be moving up and down. So, I can calculate the velocity of the pulley P1?
Yes, sir.
So, now let us try to do that one. Velocity of the pulley P1 will be equal to 4
8
plus 0 divided by 2. Oh, no?
Okay, yes, sir. 2 meter per second. Sir.
So, velocity of the pulley P1 will be equal to how much for me?
2 meter per 2
second. 2 meter per second. In which direction?
Upward direction, sir.
Upward direction, huh?
If we
I don't know Gada, in what direction it is going.
Okay, yes, sir. After
that
we get
moving
this.
In downward.
Yes, sir.
That means every time downward direction I'll take positive, upward direction I'll take negative.
Negative, yes, sir.
Now see, P1 is directly connected to P2 Gada by the string. If P1 is moving down with 2 meters per second, then P2 also moves with the same velocity in the upward direction?
Upward direction, yes.
Anagada, something like connected to the rope. So VP2 will be equal to 2 meters per second
in the upward direction.
Now I got the velocity of P2, so I know the C and B. So VP2 will be equal to velocity of C plus velocity of the B divided by 2. Simple, gada?
Yes, sir. And
velocity of P2 is how much for me? 2. Velocity of C we need to calculate. Velocity of B is how much?
4 minus 3, sir.
Divided by 2.
4 minus 3, sir.
Yeah. So this is 4 is equals to VC plus 3. So VC will become how much for me?
1, sir.
1 meter per second.
Yes, sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
So what is an answer?
1 meter per second.
Which direction?
Sir, if this is moving upwards, overall means this
downward direction, I took positive.
Okay, yes, sir.
If I'm taking downward direction positive, upward direction should be negative.
Negative, yes.
Sir. That means if we got positive kabatti, we got positive kada.
Yes, sir.
See, positive I took the in the downward direction. Isn't it? So yes, this is sir. Also we got positive. That means this body is also moving in this direction.
Downward direction, sir.
Ante kada? Because yes, both sir. The terms I got positive only, na? Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Tell me the answer for this question. If system is moving, if system is moving up with 2 meters per second square, find the tensions. Find the tensions. Okay, so this is the given diagram for us. This is 3 kg. This is your 2 kg. Chalo. So 3 kg weight will act in the downward direction because two strings gravity. Weight of this one is 3 g. In this one, there is a tension T1. There is a tension T1. Here the tension will become T2, and here the tension will become for me T2.
Yes.
Weight of this one is also 2 g in the downward direction. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, if I'm writing the equation for the T1 particulation, T1 is moving in which direction? And say, for example, the system is moving up with acceleration 2 meter per second. And this body is moving up with what velocity? 2 meter per second square.
Yes.
And I told you that in whichever direction you are moving, that direction we need to take positive.
Positive, yes.
That means for 3 kg block, T1 is moving in upward direction. T1 minus of your 3 g will be equal to 3 into acceleration 2. This is equation number 1.
Yes, sir.
For 2 kg block, T2 minus of your T1 minus of your 1 g or 2 g?
2G, sir.
This will be equal to your 2G. This will be equal to your 2G. Must be equal to your how much, beta? 2 into acceleration. That is nothing but 2. This is equation number 2.
Okay. Clear? Yes, sir.
Is that clear? Or else you take this one as 1 kg, beta. Calculation is easy. I put on this. So I'll take this one as of your 1. This is your 1 kg. So it is T2 minus T1. And here it will become for me how much, beta? 1G. And this will become for me 1 into 2. Clear?
Yes.
So now I can substitute the value of T1 from the equation 1. Okay. So from C, equation 1, tell me T1. T1 will be equal to 3 to the 6 minus equal to just a plus. 3 into G value is 10. That is nothing but 30. That means this will become 36.
36.
So now I can substitute this T1 in equation number 2. So it is a T2 minus 36. Minus 1 into G is nothing but 10. That is equals to 2. Agreed?
Yes.
So how much I'm getting T2? Can you tell me?
Minus
36 minus 10 is how much?
Minus 46. T2 minus 46
is equals to 2. That means T2 will be equal to how much?
48, sir.
48 Newton?
Yes, sir.
Got it?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me, if this system is moving in the downward direction, then what will write? Same question. In above question, if system is moving downwards, because I need only the equation, Gada.
Yes. So
this one is right now here, and this one is 1, and this one is your another one. This one is how much for me? 3 kg. This one is 0 to 2 kg. Now it is moving down with acceleration 2 m/s². Now tell me, how do you write the equations for this one? First, write the weights. The weight of this one is 3g down. The weight of the 2g down. Here there is a tension T1. This is also your tension T1. Here also tension T1, and here also tension T1 for 3 kg block. Tell me, as the body is moving down for 3g, this downward is a 3g, upward is nothing but T1, and downward acceleration is how much for me? 2 m/s².
Yes, sir.
How to write the equation,
sir? 3g then downwards.
Downward force minus upward force must be equal to mass into acceleration.
Yes, sir.
3g minus T1 must be equal to mass of that body 3 into acceleration 2. What is the Newton second law we are applying? But F net is equals to mass into acceleration.
Yes, sir.
So 3 into g is how much for me? 30 minus T1 is equals to 6.
6. Yes.
So T1 sir. Is how much?
24, sir.
20?
24, sir.
Sure,
Yes, sir.
T2?
For T2, now we have...
It is moving in a downward direction for 2 kg block.
2g minus T2 gives us...
T1 is acting down. Plus 2g is also acting down, minus T2 will be equal to 2 into acceleration. 2 into acceleration 2G, is how much for me? 2.
Yes, sir. 2 into.
Yeah. So this one T1 is how much for me? 24. Plus this one is 20, 20. Minus T2 is equals to 4.
4.
So this is how much?
44 minus
44 minus T2 is equals to 4. So T2 is how much?
40, sir.
14. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Got an idea how to do?
Yes.
Almost all any problems you have and maximum.
Okay, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Last year notes good on table, sorry. Try to take it out and try to work it out on that one also. It will help you out for you.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Okay, sir.
Sure. One more. Is it fine if I'm writing so wide?
Yes, sir.
Previous bound, na? Itlo bound. The grass is clear, bounda.
It was. It's fine, anyway, sir.
Fine, sure.
Yes.
Can you change the picture, bounda? Did
you? Yes, sir. Because I'm zooming in, sir. Sudden, sure.
See this question. No. The last time I did not. I need not concentrate on my writing.
ఓకే సార్
టకటకా వెళ్ళిపోతుంది
yes
అది చిన్నగా రాస్తే ఏమైతుంటే మెల్లగా రాయాల నీట్గా రాయాల అన్నట్టు ఉంటుంది బేసికల్
yes
సో దిస్ వన్ ఇస్ రైట్ నౌ సిస్టమ్ ఓకే 2 kg అండ్ 4 kg కనెక్టెడ్ బై ఏ స్ప్రింగ్ బెటా 4 kg ఇస్ మూవింగ్ విత్ యువర్ సే ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ 2 m/s² వాట్ విల్ బి ది యాక్సిలరేషన్ ఆఫ్ ద 2 kg బ్లాక్ క్లియర్
yes
అండ్ ఐమ్ అప్లైయింగ్ ఏ ఫోర్స్ ఆఫ్ హియర్ రైట్ నౌ 60 న్యూటన్ ఫర్ దిస్ వన్ You will get such type of questions also a lot. So what we need to do, first write the free body diagram. You know the spring force is given by the formula, F is equals to K into X.
Yes.
So there will be tension developed in this one, T. And there is also developed a tension here, T. So for the 4 kg block, tell me in which direction the block is moving. Sorry, 4 kg.
Yes, sir. Forward, sir.
4 kg is moving forward. Forward force is how much? 16 newton.
16 newton.
Backward force is how much? T. And acceleration of this one is how much? 2 m/s.
2 m/s.
That means how do you write the equation? 60 minus T is equals to 4 into your acceleration. That is nothing but 2.
Yes, sir.
And then?
Yes, sir.
See how much I'm getting? 60 minus T. 4 to the 8. So 60 minus 8. 52.
Yes.
Clear? So I got the tension T is equals to 52. If this is 2, then on 2 kg also the same one, huh?
Yes.
For 2 kg block, now tell me, for the 2 kg, this tension is how much I'm getting right now? 52. What is asking? The acceleration of this one is how much? So how do you write this one? F is equals to ma. That means T will be equal to 2 into acceleration. Isn't it? Is there any other force acting on that one body? The spring force is the tension only, beta.
Yes, sir.
Okay, there is no extension, but I'm taking the spring force is equals, because F is equals to K into X only, na? F is equals to K into X, this KX is nothing but T only.
Yes.
So now, T value is how much for me? 52. Is equals to 2 in theory. So what is acceleration? Acceleration is 52 divided by 2. So that will be equal 26. To how much? 26 meter per second square. What an idea.
Yes.
What an idea.
Yes, sir. Got it.
Akka?
Yes, sir.
This is, say, for example, 2 kg connected by your spring. And here again, this one is, say, for example, 4 kg. And it is moving with your 16 meter. I'm applying a force of 16 newton. Acceleration of the 4 kg is given as of your 2 meter per second square. And spring constant is given as of your 100 in newton per meter. Now, what is an acceleration of this one again? Think and tell me the answer. First, what we need to do, take FBD of 4 kg.
Yes, sir. 10.
So this will be 16. This will be equal to tension T develop here. This will be tension T. So this is T. This is an acceleration. Acceleration is how much? 2 meter per second square. So it is 16 minus T will be equal to your 4 into your 2.
Yes, sir.
So how much I'm getting tension? 4 to the 8. So T will be equal to 16 minus 8, 8 newton. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, even though he has given the spring constant, doesn't make any sense for us. So this is your 2 kg. On 2 kg, what is the spring force it is applying? Force T only. So we need the acceleration of this one. So again, T will be equal to how much? 2 into your A. T value is how much for me? 8. 2 into acceleration. So acceleration is how much for me? A is equals to your 8 by 2. So 2 ones are, 2 fours are. So it is 4 meter per second square. What it?
Yes.
Clear? Any doubts in this one?
No, sir. Got it.
That was about your Newton's laws of your motion particulation and with your connecting bodies particulation. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, let us try to do some tricks. Whenever we need to calculate acceleration, beta, so what you do is, so you take the acceleration, A is equals to, you always write this one as of your supporting force minus your opposing force. Supporting force minus of your opposing force divided by your total mass will give the acceleration. What is?
Yes, sir.
So what is an acceleration formula right now for me? A is equals to acceleration. A bar is equals to your. This A is equals to how much for me? Supporting force minus of your. Supporting force minus of your opposing force. Now, first we need to identify what is mean by a supporting force and what do you mean by an opposing force. Opposing force means away. Supporting means making it to move. Okay. So I'll give you some problems. We'll get an idea how to do such type of your problems related to this one. Clear?
Yes.
Let us try to do this one first. See the first question. Time on the mandakara?
Yes, sir.
This is your pulley. And this one is fixed right now here. And here there is a block of mass, say for example, EM2. And here there is a block of mass, say for example, this is passing through this one. And here there is a block of mass of your M1. So if this body is moving with an acceleration A, so obviously this body will move with acceleration A in the upward direction, beta?
Yes.
Now write all the forces on this one. So this is your EM2G. And this one is your M1G.
Yes.
Okay. See, whatever the force is in the direction of acceleration, okay, that will be supporting force.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Now tell me, what is the force which is in the direction of acceleration?
Sir, M2G and... M2G, sir.
M2G, very good. So I can say here right now, whatever force is in direction of acceleration, that will be what, beta?
supporting
force.
Yes.
Other one will be opposing force.
Yes.
Now I can write the answer directly. A is equals to what is the supporting force? M2G.
M2G.
Opposing force M1G divided by M1 plus M2. Ante kada total mass.
Yes.
So what is the answer I'm getting right now here? M2 minus M1 into G divided by M1 plus M2. Equations are also not going to be.
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
Chalo, one more practice check is on a second question. There is a pulley here right now, and here it has been fixed. And this one is, say, for example, 2 kg, and it is passing through this one. And there is another block here right now, say, for example, this one is also a 2 kg. This body is moving with acceleration here, and this body is moving with acceleration. So, what is an acceleration here right now? A is equals to the direction of acceleration. This is your 2g, and this is also your 2g. We need to take only hanging forces better. There is no hanging force in this one because 2 kg is sitting on the table very comfortably. Only 2 kg, another one is hanging. So that 2g will be your supporting force. And then,
yes.
So 2g and what will be the opposing force? There is no opposing force for that one. 0 divided by total. That is nothing but equal to your 4. And 20 divided by 4. So answer is how much? 5 meter per second square.
Yes.
Clear?
Yes.
For example, this. Let's say, for example, this is your table, and there is a block here on this one, and this one is something like this. There is one pulley here, and there is one pulley here. There is one string here, there is one string here. This is passing through this one. There is one more pulley here, and it is passing here, and there is one more pulley here. This one is, say, for example, 2 kg. This one is, say, 3 kg, and this one is your 5 kg. Okay. Now, what is an acceleration of the system? Okay, which is more weight beta here? 3 kg. So obviously this will move in the downward direction. So obviously this will move in this direction. Obviously 5 kg will move in this one.
Yes.
So now 3g is in the downward direction beta. And this one is a 2g in the downward direction. We need not write the weight of the 5 kg because it is resting on the table cover. It's okay, not an hanging force. Okay, na?
Yes.
So acceleration A is equal to what is the supporting force?
In the direction that is 3g, sir.
3g, that means 30?
Yes, sir.
What is opposing force?
20, sir.
20. Divided by total mass. What is the total mass? 2 kg plus 3 kg plus 5 kg.
Yes, sir. 10 kg.
2 kg plus 3 kg plus 5 kg. That means 30 minus 20, 10. Divided by 10. So what is an answer?
1
meter per second. Sir.
Yes, sir.
Time consume avutunda leda?
Yes.
Consume avutunda, is it reducing your time? The moment you practice
it's reducing,
it, it's comfortable
sir.
Beta. Yeah.
Yes, sir. It's
see, reducing this beta. One is this one. Here there is a pulley. Okay. And there is a here one string right now to this one. This is your 5 kg. And here there is again one more. This one is your 2 kg. And here this one is right now again for me 3 kg. So obviously in which direction the block will be moving beta? This one is more covered. This will move in this direction and this will move in the upward direction.
Yes.
So now tell me what is the acceleration of the system? A is equals to this 5G is in downward direction. This 2G is in the downward direction. These two are supporting other. In the direction of acceleration, 5G and 2G.
Yes, sir.
So 5G plus 2G is how much? 7G?
7G.
7G means much. G value is 10. 70.
Yes.
Minus another one is 30 divided by total mass. Total mass is 5 plus 2 plus 3. 10.
Yes, sir.
70 minus 30.
40, sir. 40 by 10
divided by 4. 10. So this one, this will get cancelled. 4 meter per second square. Easy.
Yes.
Like with the no, you, first you need to write the equation of 2, then you need to write the equation of 5, then you need to write the equation of 3. It will be consuming time. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Sure. Next one. This one here. This angle is your 37 degrees. And here there is some pulley right now here fixed. And one block is been attached here right now and it is hanging here. This one is, say, for example, of your 10 kg. And there is one more block on this one. And this one is also, say, for example, some 10 kg. And this string is been connected to this one like this. And this total system is been kept on an horizontal surface like this. Clear?
Yes.
Now I need to calculate again. What is an acceleration of the system? So what is this acceleration of the system? First, I need to write the forces. This one is nothing but of your 10g in the downward direction. Now for this one, if I am writing beta, This one is your 10G in the downward direction, but I need to resolve it into the components like this.
Yes.
This is 37. This is also 37. So this will become for me 10G into cos 37. And here in this direction, it will be 10 into your 10G into your sine 37. 10G into sine 37. Antena?
Yes.
And there will be one normal force here. Clear?
Yes.
So how do you write the acceleration for this side? Such type of a problems? A is equals to, in which direction the body is having the tendency to move more? Hanging body together?
Yes, sir.
So this is moving in the downward direction with acceleration A. So this will be moving with an acceleration A. So what is the supporting force?
10G, sir.
10G. What is opposing force?
That is also
10G opposite to that one. 10G into sine 37 sin opposite 37. To direction of this one. A ki opposite was none.
Yes, sir.
Divided by total mass. Total mass is how much? 10 plus 10, 20. And the acceleration will be equal to your 100 minus. This one is 100 into sine 37 is how much? 3 by 5 divided by 20. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So this one is 5 ones are, 5 twos are. Antena?
Yes, sir.
That means 20 into 3.
20 into 3 is 60, sir.
60. 100 minus 60 divided by 20.
40 by 20.
Sir. So it is 40 by 20. This one gets 2 ones are, 2 twos. The answer is 2 meter per second, sir.
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
So next one. This is a triangular shape. This angle is your 37. This angle is your 53. And this is some angle. Okay?
Yes.
In China, echo weight on the ikkada. And here there is also one weight here, right? And here there is some pulley which has been fixed to this one. And from here there is a spring which has been connecting and is going like this. Clear? This one is your 10 kg and this one is also your 10 kg. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, first what we'll do, in what direction is it having tendency to move, Devita? One slope is 53, one slope is 37. Slope is more at 30, 53, gada?
Yes, sir.
So this is having tendency to move with this acceleration here. So obviously this will be moving in this direction.
Isn't it?
Now if I am resolving it, you know, I already am writing it directly. This will become for me 10G into sine 53. And in this direction, this will become for me 10G into your sine 37.
Yes.
Because I did here right now. See, along the plane, it will be, if this is making an angle, that's the sine component of someone.
Yes.
Okay, now? So now how do you write acceleration, beta? Acceleration A is in the direction of acceleration supporting force. That means that will be equal to how much? Supporting force is 10G into your sine of your 53 minus opposing force is what? 10G into your sine of your 37 divided by total mass. That is nothing but equal to 20. That is equal to 10 into G is nothing but how much? 100. Sine 53 is how much, beta? Sine 37 is 3 by 5.
So 4 by 5. 4 by 5.
4 by 5. Minus this one is 100 into this one is 3 by 5 divided by 20. 5 ones are, 5 twos are. And it is equal to
80
minus this one is also 20. This is equals to 60
divided by
20. 80 minus 60 is how much? 20. 20 divided by 20. That will be equal to 1 meter per second square.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Turn next one.
No, sir.
Now, if I'm having the masses here right now, say, beta. Let's say, for example, here I'm having one mass, and here I'm having another mass, and here I'm having another mass, and here I'm having another mass. Like that, I'm having up to infinity.
Yes.
Up to infinity. And this all are being connected by the strings like this. And it has been passing through the another one, and it is connected to your 2 kg block. It is having an acceleration A. Okay. And each one is having a mass of, like say, this is your 1 kg. This one is your half kg. This one is your 1 by 4 kg. So on like that. Okay. So this one will be equal to your 1 by 8 kg like that. Okay. Na?
Yes.
So that is going on decreasing up to infinity. Okay.
Okay. Sir.
Now tell me, the forces acting on this one. First one is the weight of this one, 2g. So acceleration kavala manaku again a is equals in the direction of acceleration it is 2g minus there is no force on horizon on the another one kabatti opposing force zero
ante kada zero yes
divided by total is how much for me total mass is how much for me 2 plus then it is 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 plus up to infinity are you able to recollect anything 2 into g is what 20 divided by 2 plus idi infinity varaku pothe we have a basic mathematics arithmetic progression or geometric progression
sir this is arithmetic only right sir
geometric progression na 1 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 plus up to infinity. So how do you calculate in geometric progression Snth formula? Snth is equal to your a by your 1 minus 1 by r. A is your first term. R is your common ratio.
Yes.
Isn't it? So for S infinity part, how do you write this one beta? A first term is 1 divided by 1 minus. What is the common ratio between all of them? 1 plus 1 by 2
matlab difference yes,
1 by 2 1 by 4 difference 1 by 2 1 by 2 1 by 8 difference
common ratio is 1 by 2
1 by 2 that means this will become how much for me 1 minus 1 by 2 is
1 by 2
that means this will become for me how much 2
yes sir 1 minus
this is 2 so this will be equal to 20 divided by 4 that will be equal to around 5 meter per second square got it
yes sir
okay
yes
almost all maximum chesam manamo so please it all depends upon right now you to practice a lot and try to do it out clear
yes
today I have sent you some assignment beta you please try to do that one
okay, okay sir yes sir.
What did they did in the college for you beta
sir now we are doing a few questions from exercise 2 sir yes sir
ओके चलो बेटा टेक केयर बेटा बाय
यस सर थैंक यू सर बाय
बेटा